Does snail mucin really work? Hey everybody, you probably noticed snail slime is having a moment. There is snail slime in lotions, face masks, and even spa treatments where you have snails on your face. Have any of you tried either the products or the spa treatment? I'd love to hear about it in this poll. I recently went on a field trip to try it out for myself. Hey everybody, I am here in San Francisco right now, heading over to my friend Akemi's house. I'm gonna go snail hunting with her kids. The difference between a snail and a slug is the housing. Snails have a shell and slugs don't. And then I also learned that...
I found one!
No way. What? I feel like such an amateur. Oh, heck yeah. Show it to the camera. Yeah. Oh, there it is. All right, I'll take that. I actually have a pickle jar to put it in, but I didn't bring. There it is. You can see him underneath. Pretty juicy little sucker.
Are you going to put this on YouTube?
I'm going to put this on YouTube, yes. I'm also going to put this on my face. One's on. So people do this. Okay, when he gets near my eye, we can just pull it at any time. Oh God. This definitely doesn't make me feel calm. I wouldn't say calm as an experience. I feel while I'm doing this. And it really freaks me out when I can start to see their antenna and when they get towards my orifices. Like that? All right, so we'll see.
You might want to feel the side of your head.
Okay, yeah, I'll feel the side of my face. Ew, it's a little tacky. It would probably take a good 30 minutes and lots of snails to have enough goo to probably feel it and get any benefits, but what an awkward experience. After that harrowing experience, I came back and I did a little research. Historically, the earliest use of snail mucus dates back to the ancient Greeks. Hippocrates, you know, that guy who is considered the father of Western medicine, he was reported to have used crushed snails to alleviate inflammatory skin conditions. Pliny the Elder, a Roman author and natural philosopher, used the slime on wounds, burns, abscesses, and even nosebleeds. So if the Greeks and the Romans did it, it must be good, right? Right? Now there are a lot of different snails out there, but the one that we're gonna focus on is this guy, the humble garden snail. One of the more commonly used in cosmetics. It's also known as Cryptomphalus ASPERSA. In Latin, crypto means hidden, and phallus means... Maybe it's why snails were also considered to be good for fertility back in the day. Anyway, back to slime and skincare. Why are snails in your skincare products and facials? It's the slime, of course. Snails produce many different kinds of slime, and it's extracted a number of different ways. Older slime extraction methods involve dunking snails into pots of water mixed with salt and vinegar, or putting them into the centrifuge and giving them a quick spin. Sort of like little astronauts in training. Aw, cute. More modern methods involve using ozone machines or allowing snails to roam on nets, then collecting the slime. So if you care about how your snail slime is extracted, check with the brand because there's a number of ways they could be doing it. Now, reality check, the slime is mostly 90 to 99% water, but that remaining 1 to 10% gets some people pretty darn excited because some of the ingredients also appear in human skin. Like glycoproteins, which are proteins with a sugar attached to them. One of the things that they do is help skin cells communicate when they should grow and divide. Pretty important stuff for the creation of new skin. Glycosaminoglycans are long chains of repeating disaccharide units. They love water and can hold large volumes of it relative to their weight. This is what makes snail slime a really good humectant. Even though there aren't a lot of glycosaminoglycans in snail slime, a little goes a long way. It can only take a small amount to form a gel. Hyaluronic acid, it's a type of glycosaminoglycan, so we already know it's really good humectant. It's also a chief component of the extracellular matrix, the goo that holds our skin cells together. The slime also contains copper and antimicrobial peptides, which are short fragments of amino acids. Some of these copper peptides, like GHK, can do cool stuff for the skin, and some antimicrobial peptides have been shown to be effective against several strains of bacteria, like Pseudomonas, Aeruginosa, and Staphylococcus aureus. There are also antioxidant enzymes like superoxide dismutase and glutathione S-transferase, which may protect cells from the damage caused by unstable molecules known as free radicals. Some studies have shown snail slime boosts the activity of fibroblasts, factories that produce collagen and elastin, which are structural components responsible for firming up the skin. It can also ramp up the number of skin cells your body produces and may help skin cells move together in a coordinated dance to close up wounds and refresh damaged skin. This all sounds really great, except that the results reported in these studies really differ from what we experience in real life. Putting snail slime directly onto cells in a petri dish or testing on mice is not like putting snail slime onto the outermost layer of skin or testing on humans. Moreover, the studies may overemphasize the results by testing on skin that is photoaged or radiation burned. Also, some of the anti-aging molecules you're interested in, like collagen and elastin, are too big to get through the skin. So letting a snail do this to your face, although amusing, is not really doing much for your anti-aging routine. And if it's hyaluronic acid or peptides that you want, you can find them in more convenient forms. So does snail slime really work? There's no question. It's a great moisturizer. So if that's why you're using it, then slime yourself to your heart's content. But glycoproteins exist in humans not too, so I'm gonna stick to more traditional moisturizing ingredients. Is there a snail slime product that might make me a convert? Are you a fan of snail slime? Let me hear about it in the comments section below. And check out my playlist on other skincare ingredients. You can find it right here.